Well, he is best known for his role as Frankie Valli in the original Broadway cast of Jersey Boys. Joining us now is Grammy and Tony Award-winning artist John Lloyd Young. Good to see you.
Hi.
Yes.
So Clint Eastwood, of all people, this was his baby, and he picked you to play Frankie Valli. That's pretty cool.
As luck would have it, I was back doing it on Broadway again. And I didn't even have to audition for him because he saw me do the show. So can you imagine any better way to audition?
Can you tell us how that did that go down on the phone, or did he like come up after the show?
We heard a rumor. It was a Sunday matinee. Oh. He was in town to do some interviews for Tribeca Film Festival. We heard he was in town. We knew he was going to do the movie. We thought maybe we'd see him in the audience, and then we heard he's in the building.
So yes.
There was all this, you know, that's energy pretty backstage.
Now, of course, you're known for Broadway before the movie, but you do a lot more than that. You tour around the country.
After the movie came out, actually, that's been mostly what I've been doing, is touring touring around the country, building this act that now we're bringing to upstairs at Vitello's. I'm really excited. We've done this act at Clint Eastwood's private club in Tehama.
Yeah.
We've done parts of it at the White House, Kennedy Center, Michael Feinstein's clubs in San Francisco and in New York City. But I live in L.A., and don't bring this act out to play a lot here at home, so this is going to be pretty cool.
What can the audience expect? It sounds very intimate.
The venue, you know, Vitello's upstairs, old, like, think Rat Pack, old Hollywood. Remember, you know, they used to do salons in someone's living room and in someone's Hollywood house, like game night, and people would get up and they'd play the piano. Gene Kelly would do a dance, like Postcards from the Edge, except without the the dysfunctional stuff. Anyway, this is like that, you know, in Studio City, it's you go into this warm room, great Italian food, cocktails. It's very Rat Pack, and it's like a conversation, except with some great songs.
So how big of an audience would that be in that room up there?
Oh,
I mean, I've been there one time, but it's
Can't be more than 150.
That's great.
It's pretty intimate, yeah.
Definitely not north of 150, but it is like having a living room concert with your friends.
Do you enjoy that?
It's my favorite way to, I mean, I played the Hollywood Bowl where literally the top row, you have to crane your neck up like this to see the top row.
Right.
I like playing a small group of people. It's it's like having a conversation like this.
Probably a lot of just ad-lib one-on-one conversations with the audience, just the, out of spur of the moment. Yeah?
Oh, yeah, it's fun. There's nothing more comfortable. It's like, you know, you get to sit back and relax. A lot of concerts, you're standing on your feet, craning to look. You're sitting at a table with great food, you know.
What kind of songs can you hear?
The music is the dessert. Jersey Boys is always going to be on the menu in my concerts, as it was such a big show for me, and I don't ever want to disappoint anyone, and I love the songs. But what we realized, my music director, Tommy Farragher, and I, we tour around the country, we realized that the Four Seasons adjacent music, you know, Roy Orbison, Jim Morrison, Little Anthony, Smokey Robinson, that kind of, those great songs that have really fantastic lyrics and just to die for melody, those go over really well, and that's our meat and potatoes.
What do you think it is about that music in particular? I mean, you know, the 50s, the early 60s, that was a long time ago, but you still hear those songs on the radio.
Yeah.
And they're like timeless. And what is it about them that they just, that people still gravitate to it?
They're relatable. So there's one of my favorite singers ever was a Chilean singer from the 60s and 70s, and it was Victor Jara. And I'm translating from Spanish, but he said, a song that has been brave will always be new. And also, a song that has a relatable story and a great melody will always be new. So like Smokey Robinson, Ooh Baby Baby, I Did You Wrong, My Heart Went Out to Play, and In the Game I Lost You, What a Price to Pay, I'm Crying, you know.
Still goes on today.
We can all we can all relate to a breakup, and so the songs hold up.
Are so talented, and what a treat for folks here in Los Angeles to be able to experience that.
Thanks.
Yeah,
in an intimate setting at Vitello's.
Yeah. It's going to be fun.
And we actually have a really cool giveaway that we're going to give away right now. All you have to do is text YOUNG to 515151 for your chance to win two tickets to see John Lloyd Young live at upstairs at Vitello's on Thursday night or Friday night, plus a $100 dining credit at Vitello's. A fun night in the presence of this amazing performer.
Hey,
really nice to meet you, and great ring.
Yeah, thanks for coming in.
Thanks.
All right.
Thank you so much.